What is going on, guys? Welcome back into Rover Sports. During the next couple of days, I'm going to try to set up some more sessions with some other NFL personnel or other NFL buddies of mine around football. It's nice. This is my third and final video for the evening tonight, and it is actually going to be on the Sixers and the Celtics series. I watched it last night, and basically, I think the Sixers can be in a little bit of trouble because if you keep Joel Embiid in the game, Joel Embiid's going to have trouble covering Al Horford. I mean, Al Horford's a guy that could shoot the three ball at an exceptionary clip. He was 10 of 12 from the field last night. Point is, Terry Rozier is Scary Terry for a reason. He's difficult to guard. And is Ben Simmons going to guard Terry Rozier? And then Ben Simmons can't shoot. So then you're suddenly putting Bellinelli or J.J. Redick on Jason Tatum. And Jaylen Brown hasn't even come back yet. The point is, if I were the Sixers, I'd put Justin Anderson. I'd put him on Terry Rozier. I would utilize Anderson more because Anderson's a guy that's a 3-and-D guy. Justin Anderson can play defense. Justin Anderson can get into the grill of guys like Jason Tatum. He's a better defender than J.J. Redick. You might want to completely obsolete Bellinelli to like 10 to 15 minutes a play. And Ben Simmons needs to post up. Joel Embiid needs to get great post position, draw a ton of fouls, get to the foul line. The Sixers need to go ahead and they need to post up Ben and Embiid, and basically they need to run the Celtics off the line better. They need to switch. They need to play smaller. And if Al Horford continues to torch Joel Embiid, then there might be a situation where Joel Embiid might need to actually sit, ironically, for a stretch, because you might want to put a Rashawn Holmes on Al Horford for stretches. Let Embiid play a little bit, but if Horford is torching Embiid because Embiid has trouble getting out to the three-point line, don't be afraid to sit Embiid and put in Rashawn Holmes. I know that to the media, sitting Embiid sounds like the stupidest idea. He's one of the freakiest best players in our league right now. The point is that you have to cover Al Horford. And you can't cover Al Horford sometimes with Joel Embiid. You just can't. And because Embiid is a guy that sits in the paint, and Al Horford's just going to go out and drill you from the three-point line. So J.J. Redick, Bellinelli, all these slow-footed defenders at times, you got to look at T.J. McConnell, Justin Anderson. You got to be creative here if you want to win this dang series. And also, J.J. Redick, you need to pump fake. You need to take twos. You need to hit your mid-range shots. The Sixers need to slow the game down, get back in transition a little bit better, limit Rozier. Put McConnell on Rozier in a lot of instances. Force Rozier to hit the mid-range himself because he's a guy that just likes dancing around, shooting a three, whatever. And then Marcus Smart, if Marcus Smart's going to beat you, let Marcus Smart beat you. But Ben needs to post up. And when Embiid's in the game, since he's a liability defensively, he needs to be freaking awesome offensively and offset that, if that makes sense. But Brad Stevens, it was a tremendous coaching job. They basically said to the Sixers, here, Joel Embiid can go off and have 40 points. That's what they were saying, but nobody's going to shoot threes. Nobody. And the Celtics, for the past 5 years, they've had top five defense in defensive efficiency covering the three-point line. So Brad Stevens, that's why Isaiah Thomas is so awesome. It's because of Brad Stevens. It's plug and play, bro. Plug and play. He can literally plug me or you into the dang game. We could probably go off and drop 20 points in Brad Stevens' offense. I mean, the guy is a wizard with X's and O's. An absolute savant. Not even a savant, because the thing about a savant is that they're guys that just know one category of life. But Brad Stevens is a guy that is phenomenal. Fantastic, great, great coach. And that's why the Sixers are in dang trouble in this series unless they do what I said. And when they get back home, they're going to win a game. It's all about game two. Game two, Thursday night. It's going to be fantastic. One of the most intriguing series of them all. Everyone thinks because Kyrie and Hayward are out, the Celtics don't have a chance. Celtics are very much alive, and they proved it last night. They are a matchup problem with Al Horford on the floor for the Philadelphia 76ers. They are. And the Sixers need to address it. And we'll see if they do.